Today, we'll study the concept of continuity in functions. To determine if a function f of x is continuous at a point c, we only need to check three conditions. First, does f of c exist? For f of c to exist, the y value must exist when x is equal to c. In the graph shown here, if the empty point is filled with a specific value, then f of c exists. Second, as x approaches c, the limit of f of x must exist. For the limit of f of x to exist, the values of the left-hand limit and the right-hand limit must be equal. In other words, the two fingers in the picture below must meet for the limit to exist. Remember, for a limit to exist, the approaching fingers from both sides must meet. Third, if the previously determined value of f of c is equal to the limit value, then the function f of x is continuous at c. Let's summarize once again. First, if f of c exists, second, the limit of f of x as x approaches c exists. And third, if the value from the first and the second conditions are equal, then the function f of x is continuous at c. Now let's dive into more specific explanations for various cases. First condition, existence of f of c. In this graph, f of c is represented by the solid circle and its value is 3. So f of c exists and is equal to 3. In this graph, the value that makes f of c exist is represented by an empty circle, indicating that f of c cannot have any value. Moreover, in this case, there is a vertical asymptote at x equals c, which means f of c does not exist. In the last graph, although the solid circle is located outside the graph, there is still a full circle indicating that f of c exists and is equal to 1. Remember, if the point at x equals c is filled like this, f of c always exists. Second condition, existence of the limit of f of x. The limit of f of x exists when x approaches c from the left, known as the left-hand limit, and when x approaches c from the right, known as the right-hand limit, and these two limits are equal. Let's look at the graph together. When x approaches c from the left, the value of the f of x approaches 2. You don't need to worry about the presence of the hole at x equals c, because we are not substituting c into x, but rather approaching it closely. Whether the circle is solid or empty doesn't matter in this case. Now, when x approaches c from the right, f of x also converges to the value of 2. Ultimately, both the left-hand limit and the right-hand limit becomes 2, indicating the existence of the limit of f of x. Let's consider a slightly different graph this time. Take a look at the graph, and let's examine the left-hand limit and the right-hand limit. The left-hand limit approaches point A, as shown in the graph. However, the right-hand limit eventually approaches B. Since the values of the left-hand limit and the right-hand limit are different, the limit of f of x does not exist as x approaches c. In this particular graph, there is a vertical asymptote. The left-hand limit keeps going up towards positive infinity, while the right-hand limit coming from the right approaches negative infinity. Therefore, the limit does not exist. Now, let's examine all three conditions while looking at the graph. In this first graph, f of c is not visible as there is no solid point, indicating its non-existence. However, both the left-hand limit and the right-hand limit approaches 1, so the limit exists and is equal to 1. Since the first condition is not satisfied, the first and the second conditions cannot be equal. Therefore, the answer is x. In this graph, at x equals c, we observe a solid circle indicating the existence of f of c equaling 2. Moreover, for the limit values, for the left-hand limit and the right-hand limit converges to 1, establishing their existence as well as the limit value being 1. However, due to the final condition where f of x and the limit value differ from each other, this function cannot be continuous at c. What about this graph? We can see a solid circle here indicating that f of c exists and has a value of 2. However, the left-hand limit approaches 2 while the right-hand limit approaches 1. Therefore, the limit of f of x does not exist, and consequently, the third condition is not satisfied. Hence, the answer remains x. In all three graphs, f of x is not continuous at c. However, in the case of the left two graphs, we can observe that the limit exists and f of c is an empty point. On the other hand, the right graph represents a jumpy case where the limit does not exist. When f of c is an empty point, like the left graphs, refer to it as a removable discontinuity. In other words, if we fill in the solid circle representing f of c, we can create a continuous function. However, in the case of the right graph, even filling in the hole does not make the function continuous. Now let's solve two common examples that are frequently asked in exams together. The first problem is as follows. Let's consider the function f of x that has two different expressions based on whether x is greater than 3 or less than or equal to 3. When x is greater than 3, f of x is given by x squared, and when x is less than or equal to 3, it is given by 6x minus 9. To plot the graph, we can substitute 3 into each expression to find the corresponding y values. The first expression gives us 9, and the second expression, when you substitute x equals 3, becomes 18 minus 9, which is also equal to 9. We'll plot the first equation in yellow and represent the equation of the line in green. For x is greater than 3, we have the quadratic equation f of x equals x squared, and since the domain condition is x is greater than 3, we can start from the coordinate 3, 9 and draw the graph to the right. Conversely, for x less than or equal to 3, we have a line with a slope of 6 and a y-intercept of negative 9. Now, let's examine whether this function is continuous at x equals 3 by checking the three conditions we discussed earlier. Firstly, f of 3 equals 9. Secondly, the left-hand limit and the right-hand limit both converges to the same value of 9. Lastly, the previously determined values for the first and the second conditions are both 9. Therefore, the function f of x is continuous at x is 3. Now, let's move on to the last problem. This problem consists of three piecewise functions centered around x equals 3. To find the values at the boundary x is 3, we can evaluate each function separately. The first function yields 3 plus 2, which equals 5. Substituting 3 into the second function gives us 12 minus 10, resulting in 2. Finally, the third function yields a constant value of 7, regardless of the x value. Before plotting each function according to its respective domain, let's represent them in yellow, green, and orange, respectively. For x is greater than 3, the graph will be a line with a slope of 1, and since 3 is excluded, we'll draw an empty circle at x is 3. For x is less than 3, the graph will be a line with a slope of 4, and again, we'll draw a hole to exclude 3. Lastly, at x is 3, the function has a value of 7, so we'll place a solid orange circle at 3, 7. Now, let's examine whether the function is continuous at x is 3 by applying the three conditions we learned earlier. Firstly, f of 3 is the value we found earlier, which is 7. Now let's consider the second condition, the limit values. Looking at the graph, the left-hand limit is 2, and the right-hand limit is 5, so the limit of f of x as x approaches 3 does not exist. Therefore, the third condition is also not satisfied, indicating that this function is not continuous at x is 3. Today, we learned that for a function f of x to be continuous at c, it must satisfy three conditions. The importance of the continuity condition lies in the fact that a function needs to be continuous at x equals c in order to compute its derivative at that point. However, not all continuous functions are necessarily differentiable. In the next video, we'll delve into the conditions for differentiability of a function. If you found today's video helpful, please subscribe and like. Thank you for watching, and I've been your math guardian, Alex.